Hello everybody, this is Ricky Cespedes, and I wanted to talk about something that that's been on my mind for a while, and I just really kind of gathered all my thoughts and just wanted to make a video and talk about the changes that are happening in the world and changes that are happening in the U.S. in my home, the United States of America. You know, homosexuals got their 50 states acceptance of marriage and whatever. And I wanted to talk about homosexuality, the African homosexual rights, the African American rights, and the soon-to-be pedophile rights, and how much of an opposition pedophiles I am. Now the thing is though is that I was kind of like in an emotional state when I was thinking about this, because you cannot, you know, when I was younger, I used to think to myself, yeah, let's give the homosexual their rights. Because I thought that homosexuality was the final frontier of the movement of rights movements, of all movements, right of all rights movements. That was gonna be the end game. Finally, the world could be at peace. Now everybody could hold hands across the world and be happy. But no. I've been hearing on the internet that now they want to push pedophilia, and they want to make that a rights movement. They want to manifest it a rights movement. Now, I do not know how they are going to do that, because homosexuals had such a clear beginning of an influence in pop culture. There was homosexuals since the dawn of time in films, especially in the 80s, like in The Mannequin with that one gay guy that was a hairstylist, and you had other gay actors that were in films, and they're very flamboyant, and they're very charming, and they're very, you know, they fit in very well. But pedophiles, they do not have that foundation that homosexuals have. So it's going to be even harder for these corrupt individuals that are behind curtains in Congress to manifest a rights movement that the U.S. people, the people of the U.S. can relate to. That everyday people, general public, can relate to and be like, yeah, okay, let's welcome them in. Let's give them the rights. Let's do this. You know, we gave the gays their right. Well, then now we need to give the pedophiles their right. But, you know, if you really think about it, that's exactly what they want us to think. They want us to think of it as nothing. They want us to think of it as just another thing that needs to be done. Human rights. Human correction, you know, they're human beings, they need to be treated right, equally. But no, the thing is though, is that pedophiles, I just do not know how in the hell. Back in the late 90s, when I was a kid, I never foresaw in a million years that homosexuals would be getting rights. Never, you know, that was just, no one was thinking that back in the late 90s. That was not in their minds. But, you know, I can go into how people managed to accept homosexual rights, but I'm not gonna go into that. You see, the thing is though, is that the homosexuals got in through the action of conditioning. The conditioning through Congress and through the help of Congress, by putting these subjects, homosexual subjects, in schools, and by forcing themselves onto the psyche of the average individual, that we suffered. You know, we need your help. We suffered, you know, forgive us for what we've done, but we are who we are. We're born this way. Just accept us, please. Just give us our rights. And the people, the thing is though, is that it's a slow, steady process. What it is it's a facade. Homosexuals gained their way through mirror, smoke and mirror effect. Facade of a human rights thing. You know, this is what we need to do. Give them the rights. It's a facade. You know, they use a lot of gimmicks and a lot of commercials and a lot of pushing and all this stuff. And they made people believe that it was a real functional, real thing. It was through conditioning. It was through this fake conditioning. And the thing is, though, is that I think that the heart of America, Americans don't really, they haven't really fallen for it, and they really don't care about them. But they're just kind of like, yeah, we'll just give them what they want. You know, they're kind of like that. They're not all bunk gung ho running through the damn fields of fire for them. They're just kind of like, yeah, well, the Congress is backing them up. Well, they need their rights, give it to them. But the thing is, though, is that, one more thing, when the homosexuals got their 50 rights, when the homosexuals got their rights for the 50 states in the U.S., that was just another facade and another kind of flag to say, hey, you know, we're real. We got our rights. You have to accept us. Our rights movement is a real thing. Come on, wake up. It's kind of like a child winning a third place medal and running crazy with pride, saying, yes, third place. Hey, third place, everybody. Hey, I'm the best. Hey, look at me. Well, all along, everybody was like, yeah, okay. Kind of like that. That's what the U.S., the homosexuals are trying to do that, run that game, you know? But a lot of people see through them, and I see through it, too. But the thing is, though, is I want to get into is that pedophiles cannot gain the same place, because one thing, it's two sides of the coin. But the way they're going to do it is that they're going to work on one side more than the other. They're going to work on helping the adult pedophiles to polish them up, to make them look like they're normal and that the condition in which they live with is normal. And they're going to try to make it seem as though that their advances on young children is something that they cannot control, and that they're going to try to make it seem like we all have it in us or something like that. They're going to run the guilt trip like they did with gay people, the guilt trip. They ran the guilt trip with the African-American rights too. And they run this guilt trip, and it's going to be a one-sided thing. They're going to put all these rights and all this the bulk protection of the pedophiles, all this bulk, laws are going to be bent for them and all this stuff. But they forget that it's a two sides of the coin. It isn't just about one human being, it's about another. But this time it's different from homosexuals, because there's two adults. And pedophiles, one adult and one child. One child that does not have the ability to make their own decision, that may not want the advances of an adult, that may not want it. Only through conditioning will they want it, as we accepted homosexuals. It's all going to be one-sided. The child is going to lose their rights, their human rights, to fight off the advances of a grown, a damn adult. Sexual advances. It's going to be one-sided deal. The child's going to lose innocence, because a child is going to be placed in a position where they're going to have to grow up at the age of zero and have to be adult at the age of zero and have to just be accept unknowingly, putting words in their mouth, removing the ability to allow them to make their own decision. Even when they are not conscious or able to make a decision or know what a decision means, to remove that from them. Their law is going to be more left-sided, lopsided toward the pedophile adults and less on the child. But they're going to try to make it seem as though the law is working both with the adult and the child. They're going to try to make it seem as though. Now, how they're going to do that is through manipulation and conditioning. Through society, they're going to give wrong facts, incorrect facts that don't have no meat to them. They're going to create facts that are fiction, facts that don't have no scientific bone backbone. They're going to create and fabricate these things and be like, well, children, from the beginning of birth, they always had sexual needs, and they need to learn to be sexual at a young age, and it helps them be better people. And they're going to be like, and the general public is going to eat it up. And you know, the general public, we are the ones that carry the rights. We're the ones with the power. We're the ones that are carrying these idiots on our backs, pulling this big old huge statue, 100,000 ton statue of these rights, whether it's African Americans or gays or pedophiles. We're the ones that are gonna eat it up, because why? Because we're good people. We don't know what's right. The bad people are the ones that are manipulating the good people. But we need to stand up and fight against that. And it's also neurological stresses. African Americans, gay rights, and the pedophilia rights soon to come, they cause neurological stresses on the people that oppose them. Yes. The people that oppose that, the races that were against African Americans were had traumatic internal neurological stress placed upon them because they were forced to accept African Americans. They inflicted internal harm. How? Because the individual had to evoke emotions within himself, evoke emotions that caused stress within himself, internal stress, neurological stress. The homosexuals are doing the same thing, causing neurological neuroplasty stress to condition these people that oppose them. The people that oppose you are going through more harm than the people that are going through the doing the rights movement. You're causing more harm on the people that hate you than you are to them, because you're evoking emotions within them to make them go through this emotional psychological episode of internal turmoil, anger. Why don't they just stop? I don't like him. Damn it. You're causing stress, neurological stress. Maybe it's through conditioning, through the process from beginning to end. But through the process, maybe at the end, maybe someday they'll accept you. Homosexuals, pedophiles, or African Americans. I'm African American because I'm Cuban. Cubans have African American descent. But what I'm saying is that through the process, from beginning to end, you cause stress. Whatever rights movement you are in, black, gay, or pedophile, you cause neurological neuroplasty stress to force them to accept you. You put them through a process of neurological stress because you evoked emotions within them, and you invoked a stress within them, this emotional stress of anger that they already had for you. You evoked it because you placed your rights on them. Even though in time they did accept you, you put them through the process of conditioning of accepting you, you put them through a hell, through traumatic experience. It's the same way as hurting someone externally, punching or knifing them. Science has proven that emotional internal stress is the same way as being hurt externally. And that the gays and the African Americans and the pedophiles will cause this stress on the people that oppose you, gay, black, or straight. You cause stress on them. And that's as Ricky Cespedes, and I'm sorry to sell these things, but this is the truth, and science has proven it, that you're causing stress on the haters that hate you, whether you're gay, pedophile, or you're African-American. But the African-Americans, I believe, were the last right movement. They were the real ones. I have nothing against blacks, I have a black friend. But the gays and the pedophiles, there's nothing there. This is Ricky Cespedes, thank you for watching. And